Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus is done from Tarot Terra. Let's take a look and see what's going on with y'all. I am going to use, at the end, do a little clarification with the this deck that my friend Kristen, she gave me like 7 decks to, she said, I'm not using these. If you want them, you could have them. So for the Sag read, I used the Tarot of the Holy Light to clarify. For the Capricorn one, I did the Tarot of the New Vision. I just did for Aquarius, I did, this one is cute as crap, man. It's, I think it's pronounced Mibramig. It's the author's last name, or the artist's last name, the one that illustrated. But anyway, it's animals with giant heads. It's just the cutest thing ever. I mean, oh my god, it's so cute. Anyway, so we're gonna do for you all the Magical Dogs Tarot. I noticed both of them say magical, and whenever I say anything it says magical, it kind of seems hokey, right? But anyway, Magical Dogs Tarot. So we're gonna use that at the end for clarification. But we're gonna do your reading with the Wizard's Tarot, and then Wisdom of the Hidden Realms for the Oracle deck. So let's get to it. So what's going on in Pisces life? So I already shuffled, but we'll do another shuffle. I did do a pre-shuffle and just a peek. I saw the Tower card, the Death card, the Lover's card. I forget what the other one was in the middle, but it looks like you all are going through big changes in relationships. There may be endings, maybe just big transformation, maybe the end of really bad habits, the end of you putting up with some dumb shit. We just had a Venus retrograde in Capricorn, and a lot of people, and I mean a lot of people, are like, I am done with this shit. I am done tolerating dumb stuff. So, I mean, this could be you too. A lot of people are doing it. A lot of people are just like, you know what? I'm over being treated like garbage. I'm over tolerating bad behavior. I'm just done. So let's see if you're in that same boat. So, Wizard's Tarot is this one. So 5 cards. We're gonna pull 5 cards and see what's going on here. I love this deck. It is gorgeous. It's my new favorite deck that I bought. But I do like that Mibramig one. Oh my god, it's adorable. Yep, Death card again. Again. So it was the Ace of Swords, I think it's, so it was the Death card and the Ace of Swords, I think. Or no, 7 of Swords, Ace of Swords, Death card, and Lover's card. That's what it was when I did the pre-shuffle. So, I mean, there may be, so you may be not talking to someone. There may be a shutdown of communication. Someone might be trying to get away with something, or they're just keeping their thoughts to themselves. So 7 of Swords, I'm starting to see that not so much always as trying to be sneaky, shady McShadester, although often it is. But it could just be they're avoiding talking to you. They're avoiding communication. But, you know, having the Ace of Swords in there, there needs to be a new start in communication. Someone needs to speak up to clear the air, possibly. They may want to. So you get the Queen of Wands, the Magician, the Star, the 9 of Wands, and the Death card again. Bottom of the deck, Ace of Wands. So they may be wanting to make a passionate new beginning. But it looks like, you know, with this Queen of Wands, Magician, the Star, 9 of Wands, and the Death card, I almost see this as you wanting to focus on what makes you, you know, what you're passionate about. And I don't think this is so much manipulation as it's just you're trying to manifest what's ultimately gonna make you shine, what's gonna make you happy. And you're very cautious now. You're like, you know what, you're not willing, you've got, I'm not saying you have trust issues, but I don't think you trust this person. You've kind of seen their true colors. So you're willing to, but interestingly enough, look at this Death card. This isn't the kind of Death card I'm used to seeing. This almost looks like huge transformation in a relationship, whereas the people are still together. So it's like, it's not the end of the relationship, but it's a big transformation. Because look, they're still together. So this Death card is a little different. Ace of Wands is a new passionate beginning. So let's do some clarifying. I'm gonna move these up. So yeah, another Ace of Cups and the Sun card. So a new offer of love. Okay, this kitten that I just took in at the end of September is driving me crazy. So much that I now have a water bottle with his name on it. If he starts getting on my nerves, tries to jump on the table or furniture or me or anything like that. Because he's starting to feel his oats, you know what I'm saying? He's adolescent. All right, so new beginning in love. This is a Sun card is a great card to have. It shows growth, optimism, happiness. So moving forward with something with optimism. So new start in love. Okay, so the Magician, the Five of Cups, and the Eight of Wands. In the past, it looks like there's been a feeling left out in the cold. So you're quickly moving on from that. You are like, yeah, I'm done with that feeling left out in the cold. The Star card, you shining, there's another Ace. So you've got a lot of new beginnings, Pisces. Look at all these new beginnings. I mean, at the bottom of the deck, the Ace of Wands. but the Ace of Cups, the Ace of Pentacles, this is a new start in love, new start for stability, passionate new beginning. And what did I say? I think it was the Ace of Swords when I did the pre-shuffle. So you got a lot of new beginnings. With the same person or with somebody new? I have a feeling it could be with the same person. I know you may or may not want to hear that, but the Death card has the two people still together dancing and, you know, they're holding hands and dancing. So it could just be that your relationship with someone just it transforms in a huge way. Maybe they grow up. So Ace of Pentacles and the Ten of Cups. Wow. Ten of Cups is like, I mean, wish fulfillment is the Nine of Cups. The ultimate happiness is like the Ten of Cups. Your ultimate happiness. So the Nine of Wands, clarified by the High Priestess and the King of Swords. So, truth. You're still in it. You're still kind of still in it. Still, you haven't like completely shut off any, like, you're not closing the door completely. You're like, I might be willing to entertain this. Maybe. So you're very clear about what you want. You know. Like, you have that knowledge. You know what. And then the King of Swords, too. Like, you're very clear about what you want. So what is this Death card? What's being greatly transformed? Obviously, it looks like something that's been a burden in the past. Something that's been a big burden. Wow, two tens. Jeez. Okay, Pisces, this is big. All these tens and aces. So endings and new beginnings. What was a burden and made you feel either stabbed in the back or just mentally done, mentally exhausted, has been greatly transformed. Maybe you just said, you know what, go ahead, walk away. I'm not chasing you. I'm done with it. I'm not doing it. But the Ace of Pentacles is in the very heart of all this. So it's a new beginning that's stable. A new stable beginning. I like this. Look at this card. This is what's in the center. If I can pick it up. But it has the Star above it and the Ten of Cups beneath it. Look at this. Can I focus on it so you can really see it? But look at that. I know. Look at those nails. is there a way I could do this? We don't have to look at my nails. Yeah, look at this. It's beautiful. That is a beautiful card for, you know, Ace of Pentacles. But that's right in the heart of your reading. And do we have rainbows? Do we have rainbows anywhere? I don't see rainbows. Not necessarily. I was going to say, actually, I do have a rainbow. So there may be some people here in this watching this reading that are in the LGBTQ community. because I have the rainbow, and then I have this one has all the colors of the rainbow, and this one does as well. So that's three times. Usually, what they say, it's like threes or confirmation. He's about to work. Ugh. He's about to work my last nerve. But yeah, the Ace of Wands. If you have all the aces, all four aces. You was, like I said, the pre-shuffle, you had the Ace of Swords, so. Yeah. New beginnings. Ending bad behavior and putting an end to it and starting new with love, passion, and stability. You can't go wrong with that. All right, so what oracle card or cards? Pull one and then we'll see what's on the bottom. How about that? Let's do that. So, top of the deck, we've got Gaia's Garden. Fruition, abundance, reaping what you sow. So it's almost like karma. But good karma, because, you know, you've done the work. You know, you're growing a garden, and you're growing it. That sounds so tacky and weird, doesn't it? But what you've put in motion, where's the magician? What you've put in motion, you're reaping the rewards of it. I almost feel like, shouldn't we see the Empress here? But we don't. But, you know, with the Abundance card, I feel like the Empress should be here. So, and the Map Maker of Destiny, authentic purpose, inspiration, and free will. So, once again, you know, reaping what you sow, but free will, I mean, you have choices, but you're making good choices, it looks like. I like it. So let's take a look using this one, the, what is it, the dog's, oh, I already forgot. The Magical Dog's Tarot. All right, so let's see, what is your person up to right now? The person you came here to hear about, or that you most recently dealt with. Okay, so C is like cups. So Six of Cups, probably reminiscing, looking over text messages and pictures of y'all. C, Alpha Female. Okay, so that would be Queen of Cups. And whenever, to me, Queen of Cups is usually more about taking care of yourself, nurturing yourself, licking your wounds, you know. So what else? The Death card again. Transforming. In this case, I almost feel like it's growing up. And this is why. Look at, this is their version of transforming, the Death card in the Dog's Tarot. And almost, see how he's like taller and wiser and he's become, it looks like this dog has risen up and transformed, but see how it's like, oh, I forget what's the Egyptian, it's not Tiamat, I can't remember the name of this particular one, this god in Egyptian mythology, but it's the dog. But see how it's almost like he graduates, evolves, elevates, grows up, matures. So you might have somebody who is maturing. It could be emotional maturing because you have the C and then C twice. So Six of C, C Alpha Female, and the Death card. I mean, I think that's emotional transformation. So someone could be evolving, believe it or not. All right, so what else? Let's take a look. You have Seven of Earth. That's Seven of Pentacles. So looking over how far you've come, what's been achieved, what you know, what you've been through. Who is this person? Four of Cups. That's a Cancer card. Two of C. Look at all these emotions. This person, whoever this is, Pisces, your person is emotional. Two of Cups. Look at that. And it's also a Cancer card, too. And then the Ace of Fire. So that's Aries, Leo, Sag. But it also could be someone who is known for starting things, starting passionately, starting things. They're really good at starting things passionately. And it could be someone who's like a soulmate. I mean, I hate to use that term, but I mean, Two of Cups is usually a soulmate card. If you're going to look at it, you know, cards that are soulmate. And let's see, Six of Cups, Two of Cups. I forget, there's like four of them that are like soulmate type cards. But yeah, the Two of C is like the Two of Cups. They're, you know, soulmates. So it could be someone who, you know, you consider a soulmate, they consider you a soulmate. But, and they may be disappointed. Disappointed with how things went. They're not seeing the love that they have in front of them. They're looking back at what was lost. So it could be like somebody who is easily disappointed. They focus on the negative. But I think they've actually done some emotional evolving. Believe it or not. I know. You're probably like, bullshit. This person, they're immature. They're never going to grow up. Screw them. But they may have actually done some evolving. And it might be because you just kind of shut them out. Been like, you know what? Screw you. I'm done. So we are reading for Aries next. So let's do six cards, Donna's Destiny, and then we're going to go on to Aries. So let's see. Six cards, Donna's Destiny. Pisces, who you've been dealing with. All right, so, oh yeah, this is for me, to you, and everybody watching. Thank you. Thank you to everyone who has hit like, share, subscribe, commented. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Every once in a while, I got to remind myself, because I kind of forget, unfortunately. I forget to say thank you sometimes. Make them put in more effort. Ooh, yeah, we're going to, I have a feeling that one's going to be held up. Buy the shoes. Why do I keep telling people to buy the shoes? That keeps coming out. Well, okay, everybody, buy the shoes. They have abandonment issues. I have a feeling that's going to be held up. Yep. Stop being petty. Stop being stubborn. Okay, it did call you out for being stubborn, so you might be stubborn. Dream bigger. Pisces, you're pretty good at dreaming, you know, big as it is, right? You're usually good at, you know, and having that dream, but this is what I want you to be aware of, because this could be why they act like such a shit. They have abandonment issues, and make them put in more effort. All right, Pisces, I love you guys, and I will see you in the next read. All right, Aries is next. Bye.